for a week now. Over the weekend, actually on Saturday, November the 16th, Lakeith Stanfield, who's a prominent black actor, he's been going back and forth with Charlamagne, saying a few things. He actually dropped a diss song called Automatic, going at Charlamagne and some other people. Now, first and foremost, it kind of started where the actor pretty much called out World Star Hip Hop, The Breakfast Club, The Shade Room, and Lipstick Alley. He goes on to say, it's a fact that a lot of these platforms are usually or tend to be feeding grounds for negative reinforcement towards black nonconformists. They bolster false vanity and hold white supremacist scope over black men and women, often highlighting negative attributes and downplaying mind-expanding ones. They serve as bottomless cowards, consumption pits, and digital and audio and otherwise slave mentality museums. Now, November the 14th, like you were saying, Sam, man, Charlamagne pretty much gave him, I think, the donkey of the day.
By the name of Lakeith Stanfield. You know Lakeith Stanfield, right? He plays Darius on the TV show Atlanta. You may know him as Andre from Get Out. Remember, he was the black man who went missing. And then when Chris hit him with the flash at the brunch auction Klan rally, he flipped out. Yeah, that brother. Well, yesterday he posted this on Instagram. He posted The Shade Room, Lipstick Alley, Breakfast Club, World Star, and many others are or anti-black. That's how he typed it. He said, and many other are, A-R-E, then typed or, R, O-R, anti-black. I guess he didn't know which word to use or how to use it, so he decided to do both, to be safe. I get it. Now, I had a great session with my spiritual counselor, Yachty, last night, dropping a clues bomb for Yachty. I also have therapy Friday at 3. One thing that my therapist and spiritual counselor allowed me to see is the God and everything. Everything is God. So even though this statement pissed me off for a second yesterday, it did. And I'll tell you why. I'm still going to see the good of God in this statement and use it as an opportunity to teach Lakeith. Because, Lakeith, you have to practice what you tweet, or in this case, post on the gram. Now, first of all, I breathed all of this out last night during my spiritual counseling session. I grounded myself, brought myself back to center, and released the anger. Because I know Envy was trying to rob me up when he sent this to me yesterday. Okay? I released all this anger last night I had for this statement. Because, you know, you can say any and everything about me. I've damn near heard it all about myself online. But what you won't do is ever fix your lips to call one of my platforms, especially The Breakfast Club, anti-black. All right? Let me read the caption Lakeith Stanfield put with this meme. He said, it's a fact that a lot of these platforms are usually or tend to be feeding grounds for negative reinforcement toward black nonconformists. They bolster faux vanity and hold a white supremacist scope over black men and women, often highlighting negative attributes and downplaying mind-expanding ones. They serve as bottomless coward consumption pits and digital audio or otherwise slave mentality museums at All You Want. End quote. I don't know what the hell Lakeith Stanfield is talking about, but I do know myself, Charlamagne the God, in the 9 years I've been on this Breakfast Club, I strive every day to be the perfect balance of ratchetness and righteousness. All right. There's not another show out there that goes from Byron Allen to Black Youngster like it's nothing. All right. You tell me a show where the guest list goes from the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan to 21 Savage. This show has gone from me talking about sucking farts out of women's asses to me encouraging brothers and sisters to go to therapy and invest in their mental wealth. You know why, Lakeith? Because that's life. And that's the way life works. Okay, I'm not going to sit here and act like we've gotten it right all the time, because we haven't. We've made plenty of mistakes on this radio. Plenty of things I've looked back on and said, yeah, we should have played that a certain way. And all that critique is fine. But Lakeith Stanfield, don't you ever fix your raggedy ass mouth to call the author of Black Privilege, because I truly believe it is a privilege to be black, anti-black. Okay? Ask all those white people who call up here every day complaining about me saying cracker ass cracker or mayonnaise, or asking me why everything gotta be black and white. All right? Ask them, okay, if I'm anti-black. Don't ever fix your mouth to call a brother like me anti-black, because Young King, I know for a fact you don't take the chances that I do every day in the name of blackness. All right? That's a
Oh wow. Charlamagne felt some type of way about that shit.
Yeah.
Before we talked about releasing with God about 14, 15 million times. Before I get...
Okay, I'm going to try to get through this without using ad hominem attacks and silly little things about your own personal life, because I don't think that's really what we have to hear. We have to do the issues and topics at hand. Now, you just illustrated that sometimes you bring good guests, sometimes you bring bad guests. And that's kind of what I hinted to in the subtext of what you just read. Basically, what I was saying is outlets like yours have a tendency to lean toward highlighting negative things. And that's true. And if you don't understand that we engaged in a war, that it's a war to be black in this bitch, that means if you ain't on the team moving things forward, then you're against the goddamn team, period. So if y'all doing more of that bullshit, then that shit goes under the umbrella, which I will admit is a generalization, but the umbrella of anti-black. And that's what the fuck I'm talking about. We're going.
First of all, I just think that, man, you know, first, I agree, you know, with a lot, you know, what Lakeith is saying. When you look at a lot, once again, now the Breakfast Club, you can kind of put them into a separate category, former world star and different things. There's different categories here. But I look at the overall scope of things, and I always compare it to, you know, other groups of people. That's the best thing to do. And you look at, you know, black wealth, you look at the black exploitation films. You know, the condition of a lot of black neighborhoods, the joblessness rates, and just the overall health and mental health. And Charlamagne talks about that a lot, of black people is not, you know, I think where it should be. You know, a lot of things, you know, are deteriorating. I just think that when certain outlets continue to highlight and promote the things that they promote, the negative stereotypes, the negative things going on, like we clicked on an Instagram today, we seen Breakfast Club talking about somebody got fired from Popeyes to help for their son coming in, helping them make chicken sandwiches. Like some of the stuff that they promote on there, and not even Breakfast Club, but mean like a world star in these different outlets, would I think would fuel these stereotypes and have other people have this perception of us one way. But again, even us, a lot of people say that about us. Oh, y'all talk about this, but we try as much as we can to show a positive thing. Like we'll do something on Master P, you know, getting a business, you know what I mean? Starting something with his sneakers, or Jay-Z and his business deals and wealth here. We'll bring on business guys. So we try to, as much as we can, balance those scales, because at the end of the day, what's selling and what people are clicking and interested in is a lot of that ratchetness as well. So it's not only on the outlets, it's on the people as well for consuming it, because if they ain't consume it like that, these different outlets wouldn't pump it. Worldstar wouldn't put a video up, you know, two people fighting in the street if it didn't get 1 million hits in 2 hours. You know what I mean? But again, somebody's going to have to be held accountable, you know, for this. And I think that it's a two-edged sword with this. But yeah, what us as black people, it's just different than everybody else. So I got to take that stance with it, man. Definitely.
You know, I have to agree and go along the lines with what Lakeith said as well. Yeah. Breakfast Club has broken a lot of gaps and bridged a lot of gaps, I should say, in the culture, and brought on a lot of people, like Charlamagne said, that we've never would customarily see. Nice. If in fact they wouldn't bring them on, and were a lot of motivators for a lot of the things you see people doing today. Great job. But, and I didn't hear it all, but where was the accountability at? Because other outlets do, and you are the main stage of that outlet. So where is the accountability at? Now, you said that you wish that you would have looked back at some things and maybe did some things different, but you also can't really fix your face out to feel disrespected by what he said either, because he never called you out by name. He called you out by platform. And when you see and you go through your timeline, if you're sitting here tired and upset of looking at the narrative be so negative, and you see a Popeye chicken ad and you over that shit and you see it happen coming from Power 105, that's the Breakfast Club. You associate the two. It is what it is. So, I mean, check the source. Don't check the person saying it. Don't check the messenger, Charlamagne. Right. I think that was a little bit far-fetched of him doing prior to him really understanding where the brother came from. He's tired of seeing negative or real disgusting narrative when it comes to our people, and the things that get driven are the fights, are the ratchetness, are the shaking of the ass, or this, are that. And it's like, we're getting tired of that, man. We want to see things in a different light, in a more positive light.
Facts.
Have a little bit of the combination of both, because yeah, if it's going to move, if it's going to move the people, then you do have a business. You got to go and do what you got to do to promote your business, but let there be a positive underlying even in what you promote. You said us, we got to take accountability in that as well. And we try to the best of our abilities, being in the media game, deciding, okay, we're going to create business in media.
Right.
So we're going to accept the negative connotation that comes with being in media. And some of that is, hey, we got to come in here, oh God, and look at what we got going on today. And sometimes this is something that we may not usually talk about. Right. But we got to go there because we run a business. We got to do the best we can while we get into the belly of what we're going on to give the most positive and real perspective. But we got to go there. This is the business.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
and a lot of these, you know, platforms are to the point now where if they were able to spin it right, they would be able to still promote a lot of positive stuff and stay alive. Like some people, you know, they, you know, that they got to put the ratchet shit up there to keep it going. But some of these platforms got these multi-million, you know, followings. They can always, you know, promote more, you know, of that. But they're going to keep doing it. When you talk about these platforms, as long as people click, when they see somebody get punched in the face or a celebrity, somebody getting robbed and chain snatched, and mm-hmm. as soon as it goes up, it's at a million views in 5 minutes. On Instagram, it's going to continue, you know, to happen. But definitely a great point. It needs to be called out. It needs to be talked about. I'd like to see these two brothers have a conversation face-to-face on the show. I think that'd be dope.
I think we will eventually see him on The Breakfast Club, and they'll be talking it out face-to-face. It's only right. I mean, if you got a platform where it's open like that, and he was on The Breakfast Club at one point before. I don't know if Charlamagne was at that Breakfast Club interview. I'm actually looking at the thumbnails now. Damn, they got a million views. I don't know when it dropped or what, but
right.
I mean, the brother's doing his thing, super talented, obviously has a good head on his shoulder, a clear head on his shoulder, got some things to say. I think it would be a great conversation.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah, man, that was a great, you know, conversation. Real quick before we get out of here, I was just, an article popped up and I thought it was a little interesting real quick. We probably won't talk about it, you know, but it was a list that pretty much dropped of the rappers, like how much they, you know, would get for bookings and whatnot. I'm just looking at it now. It's pretty interesting.
Well, you had to crack up.
Like you, I mean, some people getting, all right, let's see. Ludacris, it says generally 80 grand.